Before the war was broke, really did break out, they all fixed us up with an Anderson shelter in the yard. It was like a corrugated iron, and it was dug so far into the ground, and then we had to cover it all over with earth, make it as safe as we could. Well, ours, we had to be dig a sump in at the back end, because we used to have to go and ladle water out with buckets. It filled up with water, and it was clean as anything. And we used to have to throw all these buckets of water away, and then my husband fixed a board halfway across, and I used to keep a spare mattress in the house to keep it aired. And when the sirens went, we used to take this mattress in and put it across, and there used to be a neighbour of mine and myself and the two boys all on the bed, and her husband used to have a box at the side, and that's how we used to have to stop while the all clear went. Well, we used to have many a night, as people remember. But on December 1940, it was on the Thursday, they came to Sheffield, and it was terrible. It was a ruinous thing, and the people that got killed there was a lot, and the damage done. Then they came again at the Sunday, and on the Sunday they went during the afternoon, and everybody was terribly afraid. They thought they were coming in the daylight, but they didn't. They came again after tea, and that was one of the worst nights that we had. You could hear the bombs whistling, and we used to keep thinking, oh, this one's ours. And you could hear the bangs and the guns. It used to be a gun sight on top of the manor. You could hear them firing, and then you could hear explosions and that, and you could fair feel the earth trembling with the shocks of the explosions. And then there was a lot of incendiary bombs dropped, causing fire. And when it was all over, and we came out of the shelter, well, we were really surprised. Our houses were all intact on our road, but all around it, it was one mass of fire. And the people that were left homeless, it was scandalous, and they were digging them out of the shelters. Some were all right, some were badly injured, some were even dead. In fact, one air raid shelter for the ARP wardens, where they had to stand, that got gutted, and I think they all lost their lives in that one. And it was terrible, the things that went off. And then gradually, we just used to have the air raids and an occasional shooting, but they used to have all these balloons that went up in the air. And when they went up, we always used to know they were getting ready for a siren going. They used to call on red alerts and blue alerts, purple alerts, there used to be all sorts. But when the sirens used to go, bang, straight into the shelters. But the worst experience of the bombing, I think, was when they sent them A2s, were they, something, flying bombs. Mm. Oh, that were terrible. The one came over one night, and we were just getting up to go in the shelter with the sirens and guns. And I remember hearing this, ooh, they did make a row when they come past. I said, it came past, and we could just see the flame at the end of it. I said, I dropped down on the floor at the side of the bed, and I thought, oh, we shan't escape this one. But did it. It went past us, but some poor soul caught it. And when they dropped, it was an explosion. And it did cause some havoc. There used to be terrible death rolls with them.